The New York Police Department's point man on terrorism, Deputy Commissioner John Miller, joined us a short time ago here in Studio 57. He's a former FBI assistant director. We asked him how intelligence agencies could completely miss any warning of that attack in Paris.
Here's a group of people that flew under the radar and probably did so using these communications apps that can't be seen by law enforcement, can't be opened by court order, that are this new design that are becoming increasingly popular.
Michael Morell, the former number two at the CIA, is now CBS News senior security contributor and joins us again from Washington. Michael, good morning.
Good morning.
To this discussion that John Miller was having, we were talking about, how disturbing is it, Michael, that this completely escaped the radar of French authorities?
I think it's very disturbing. What you had here was a number of individuals working together, putting bombs together, multiple locations. That takes a lot of planning, and that flew completely under the radar. I think that's very, very worrying, and it shows a level of sophistication that we have not seen since the London bombings in 2005.
You mentioned those multiple locations, and I think as people wake up and hear more about the details, that's the most alarming detail. It, Friday night, bustling French city, and you have them going after bars and restaurants and soccer stadiums. Are those targets significant?
So I think what the attackers had in mind was to strike at the heart of French society, and what they're trying to do, and they're going to fail, but what they're trying to do is change the political dialogue in France to oppose what the French are doing in Iraq and Syria against ISIS. That's what they're trying to do, but they're obviously going to fail.
Michael, you see an evolution in terrorism here. I mean, for a while it seemed like they were attacking, you know, prominent targets. Now we have some what seemingly very sort of random sites in Paris. The game is changing?
I think the game's changing. Al-Qaeda was a group that was focused on catastrophic, large-scale, history-changing attacks. That's why they focused on large buildings and aircraft. I think what the terrorists have learned over time is that they can create just as much terror by attacking small targets where people just are going about their daily lives. And I think that is an evolution here that is extremely worrying.
Yes, it is a frightening evolution, to say the least. Michael Morell, thank you so much.